you ever use any Cruppers, however you want to pronounce it? No? Okay, never mind. They answer, your students answered it for
you. Yeah, okay, here's the deal. Tail Crupper, everybody understands Tail Crupper, right? Mm-hmm. Last year I was amazed. Three people called me and said, I'm going to get your saddle, but does it have a place for a Tail Crupper ring? I say, no. They say, well, we want you to put a Tail Crupper ring on. I said, no, this is my saddle. I designed it this way. Well, why don't you like a Tail Crupper ring? I said, because number one, the saddle moves 2.5 inches forward. Number two, you got a good chance of breaking the mule's back. One guy says, son, I've been doing this for 30 some years. And he said, I've never broke a back one. Had another lady tell me the same thing. I've been riding all my life with a Tail Crupper. Had a young, the third one said, now I'm just getting started. I want to use a Tail Crupper. Okay? And I went through the whole mess with them. Understand, a Tail Crupper is only on bone. It's not on muscle mass. All right? Now, I'll talk about britchen and stuff later. But long story short, all three of them people within a month called me and said they had to put their mules down because they had broken backs because of the tail. The Crupper broke the tail. One guy said I loosened it up because the it was rubbing the underside of his mule. He loosened it up, so now the tail was sticking up, and it just snapped. He said, I heard it snap. And he said, every one of them said, I could feel the back end of the animal just drop and literally scoop like this. That had to be horrible. Had to be horrible. And when I talk about breechings and adjustments, you'll see why I use a breeching. Because you see, the breeching is not going to stay in one place all the time.